Okay, so we were hearing about Bharat Maharaj and how Bharat Maharaj took the body of a deer at the time of death. He had an unfortunate accident in the mountains. He fell off the cliff and he thought of the deer at the time of death, and he became a deer in his next life.
我们前几课一直在讲述巴拉特马哈拉什的故事。他死亡之后呢，成为了一头鹿。有一个不幸的事件发生了，他从山峰上山顶上摔下去了。当他死亡之际，他想着那头鹿，所以下一世便投生为一头鹿。
So although he had been a devotee and he was very advanced, he had renounced everything, he'd given up all attachment to the material world. Somehow, by the will of providence, he became attached to the deer.
他真是一个非常进步的奉献者，并且弃绝了一切，放弃了对物质世界的依附。但是由于命运的意志， 他下一世投生为一头鹿。
So because he neglected his spiritual practice to take care of the deer, his consciousness became affected, his consciousness became absorbed in the thought of the deer instead of his spiritual practice.
因为他忽视了灵修，而从转而依附了一头鹿，因此他的知觉便受到了影响。所以，因为他专注于这头鹿，所以他的灵修便受到了严重的影响。This
example of Bharat Maharaj shows us how dangerous it is to engage in welfare activities for the benefit of other living entities.
Bharat Maharaj的这个事例就向世人表明，从事于对其他生物体的福祉是极其危险的。
If we're not able to elevate them spiritually, then there's no benefit.
如果我们不能
able to elevate the living entity to the spiritual platform, then there's no benefit to our trying to help them.
如果不能在灵性层面上提升这些生物体，那么就没有什么好处。
We have to be able to bring them up to the spiritual platform, but you cannot bring an animal up to the spiritual platform.
我们必须能将它们提升到灵性层面，但是你无法能把动物提升到灵性层面。So
Bharat Maharaj took the body of a deer, but he was able to remember his previous life.
Bharat Maharaj 他投生为一头鹿，但是他还能记得他的前世。
So he was not attached to anything, he was not attached to his material situation.
他并不依附他的物质的情况。He
did not become attached to his mother deer. Although he was in the body of a deer, he did not become attached to the mother deer who gave birth to him. He left that home.
母鹿，虽然他从母鹿的子宫当中出生了，他也离开了家。And
after, as soon as he was able to walk a little bit and look after himself, he left the mother deer and he went back to the place where he had been living when he was in his previous life, when he was Bharat Maharaj. He went back to that place where the Gandaki River was.
能站起来走路，他就离开了他的母亲，就前往他前一世曾经灵修的地点 Gandaki 河流经的那个地方，那是他前一世作为 Bharat Maharaj 居住的地方。
So, association is very important. When we get association with devotees, we're very fortunate. We should understand that association is meant to help us go back to Godhead.
奉献者的联谊是非常重要的。如果能得到奉献者的联谊，那是非常幸运的。我们应该明白，奉献者能帮助我们回归神首。
It is not recommended that we remain attached to our birthplace and the family in which we have taken birth in. These things are not going to help us to become Krishna conscious.
并不建议我们依附于自己的出生地，也不能依附自己所出生的家庭，这些都不能帮助我们成为 Krishna 之觉。
We should take shelter of the association of devotees and the Krishna consciousness movement.
我们应当在 Krishna 之觉运动当中脱离于奉献者。
So in the body of the deer, Bharat Maharaj was very careful where he went and who he associated with.
在鹿的躯体当中 ，Bharat Maharaj 非常小心谨慎，他去哪里，和谁联谊。
His only association was the super soul in his heart.
他唯一联谊的对象就是居于他心中的超灵。
So he remained in that place in the mountains where he'd been living before as Bharat Maharaj, and there he would live only on eating dry leaves.
他居住在他前世作为 Bharat Maharaj 所居住的那个山里头，他唯一的食物就是掉下来的干枯的树叶。
And he would bathe in the holy river, the Gandaki river, which was flowing there.
他在流经那个地方的 Gandaki 圣河中沐浴。
And he was, after some time, he was able to give up that body of the deer.
过了一段时间，他便放弃了作为鹿的躯体。
So, it's important to be able to go to a holy place to do devotional service. It's very powerful.
能去圣地从事奉献服务非常重要，因为在圣地是非常有力量的。
Especially when we're preparing to leave the body to go back to Godhead.
特别是当我们准备放弃躯体回归神首的时候。
So you go to the holy place, you can take bath, just like in Vrindavan, you can take bath in the Yamuna, in Mayapur, take bath in the Ganga.
在 Vrindavan, 圣地 Vrindavan, 可以在 Yamuna 圣河当中沐浴，而在 Mayapur, 可以在神圣的恒河当中沐浴。
Then by hearing and chanting the holy name regularly, and hearing the pastimes,We get very purified, we become ready for liberation.
通过有规律的聆听和唱诵，通过聆听主的逍遥时光，我们便获得净化，能够做好准备。
But if we're not careful, we may fall victim to sense gratification.
我们可能堕落到感官享乐当中。
And if we fall victim to sense gratification, then we will get punished. at least for one lifetime.
如果我们成为感官，
Haribol?
Hare Krishna, Gurmani Madaji, 我们听不到你了。Haribol?
事儿啊 ，Gurmani Madaji。Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Krishna, Hare Krishna.Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Gurmani Madaji 那儿，他那儿网络信号不太好，可能就是，但是他能听见我们，可能他那儿就有断续。我让他再试一次，然后如果实在不行的话，看看，我们再联络其他人，或者让冉仁帕布翻译也可以。
可以。
可以吗
？OK。
好的 ，Gurmani Madaji。
现在。
好，那我们再试一下，现在可以听到，嗯。
好，再试一下。
Okay, so Bharat Maharaj, he took the body of the deer, and then he had to stay in that body of the deer for some time, and then he took his birth again. Next life, he took birth in a very pure Brahmana family.
投生为一头鹿，他在鹿的身体当中停留了一段时间，随后在下一世，他投生在一个非常纯洁的 Brahmana 家庭当中。
The Brahmana was very qualified. He had all the Brahminical qualities.
这位 Brahmana 是非常有资格的，拥有所有 Brahmana 的品质。
He studied the Vedas.And he was very good in giving charity.
他研习韦达经，非常擅长给予布施。
And he always liked to do devotional service.
他总是从事奉献服务。
He had 9 sons by his first wife.And he had a second wife, the younger wife, and from the younger wife, he had twins, one boy and one girl. And it said that child, the boy from the twins, he was Bharat Maharaj.
据说，
Hare Krishna. 不行，又不行了。Guru, good day. 我看不行，我们请那个冉任帕布来翻译好吗？但是可能我们得用微信，可以吗？
可以。
您那可以，可以是吧？那我们先挂断，然后我用微信来呼好吗？
用微信呢？
对对。
OK。
我们试一下。
找了小冠那个 Skype 啊。
对对，那个冉任帕布那儿，他可能是 Skype 不太方便。
Okay.